Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Kenny Ravish, concerned epileptologist working at HRV Hospital, JP Nagar, Bangalore. Today I'm here to talk about what is epilepsy surgery. Now, as you all know that in any patient with epilepsy, the first and foremost line of management is giving medications. So these medications which are given for epilepsy help to control seizure in 80% of people, but in the rest 20% of people with epilepsy, despite taking medications, they tend to have seizures. So in these patients, we should try to find out if there is any surgical option which can help in reducing the seizures. The surgical options in epilepsy include mainly either two types. One in which we can cure the patient of the seizures and other in which we can reduce the seizure frequency. So for curative surgery for epilepsy involves either removing a small area of the brain which is responsible for seizures, it's not lesionectomy, or involves removing a particular lobe of the brain which is responsible, like temporal lobectomy, frontal lobectomy, etc. Or sometimes where the epilepsy arises from broader area of the brain, like which may involve two or more lobes, we do multilobar resection. And when entire hemisphere of the brain or one half of the brain involved, we do hemispherotomy. So these are the various surgeries which can help in reducing the patient's seizures and even completely curing some. So in certain patients in whom there is no permanent cure available, where the epilepsy in certain cases arises from both areas of the brain, in those patients we should try to help in reducing the seizure frequency either by doing a procedure known as calcitomy, wherein which we break the connection between two areas of the brain. There is a bridge is there known as the corpus callosum. So by breaking this bridge, the patient's drop attacks, like certain men they fall down, this drop attacks are reduced by doing this corpus callosotomy. Other procedures involve battery implantation, which may be either in the vagus nerve or also in the other areas of brain and thalamus by doing a deep brain stimulation. So these are the various brief overview about the various surgical procedures which are done commonly for epilepsy surgery patients. Thank you.